We've heard it said a number of times that the best offer of vehicle is the one you own. Of course, in an ideal situation, you will be able to get behind the wheel of your dream 4x4 and take it on some epic adventures. That being said, picking up the best classic off-roader isn't as simple as going to a manufacturer's website and picking out an off-road ready trim, as they're no longer in production in a traditional sense. So we have rounded up the world's best classic off-roaders of all time. One of the oldest civilian pickup trucks built specifically with off-road driving in mind, the Dodge Power Wagon is an all-terrain legend, if there ever was one. Not only did it feature a ruggedized chassis that was built to handle sand, water, mud, snow and more, but the first series also came standard with its own front-end winch, meaning that they could actually save themselves in the off chance that they ever got stuck. With 94 horsepower, they weren't speed demons, but they made it up for it with an impressive, at the time, 195 foot-pounds of torque. Few vehicles in the history of the automotive industry have had the staying power of the first generation Ford Bronco. With a production run that lasted 12 years, this 4x4 SUV is still in high demand today, with restored and beefed up examples selling for hundreds of thousands of dollars, depending on their condition. Of course, the Ford Bronco was also an immediate hit when it came out, despite the fact that the industry had already produced a number of similar vehicles. Fairly simple and straightforward, this 4x4 boasted full-time four-wheel drive, an easy-to-remove fiberglass top for open-air driving, and a solid and reliable suspension system ideal for all-terrain driving. It's also worth noting that while the initial release came with only 105 horsepower engine, a much beefier 200 horsepower V8 option was introduced shortly after. Based on the M998 Humvee, which was originally a strictly military-only vehicle, the Hummer H1 was one of the largest and most capable stock off-road SUVs of its time. The first street-legal civilian version was also famously purchased by none other than the Terminator himself, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Over the course of its production, five different engines were included as stock options, none of which were smaller than a 5.7 V8 engine. And while having some seriously burly powertrains definitely made these vehicles formidable on and off-road, they also had a number of other features that upped the ante even further. They include enduring stability, thanks to their extremely wide stance, the ability to throw waters up to 30 inches deep, the ability to climb steps up to 22 inches in height, and a good deal more. The production of this vehicle ceased in 2006, making way for two widely panned subsequent generations. The first mass-produced civilian version of probably the most legendary American 4x4 vehicle of all time, the Willys Jeep CJ2A, was largely the same as its military counterparts, offering very little in the way of comforts, with a heavy focus on capability instead. Where they did differ, however, was in that the civilian version came with a rear tailgate, a side-mounted spare tire, and bigger bulger headlights. Still, the CJ2A was built with utility in mind, especially for use in farming practices, meaning it came standard with only one driver's seat and driver's side view mirror, but was offered with the option to upgrade it with passenger seating, a simple canvas top, and a good deal more. The legendary design language of the CJ2A would go on to define much of Jeep's business, with styling cues borrowed from the CJ series that are used up to this day, especially in regards to the Wrangler SUV and all its permutations, including the new Gladiator pickup truck. After the success of their military vehicles turned civilian workhorses, Jeep looked to expand its range with offerings that were a bit more comfortable. That resulted in the production of their first luxury 4x4, the Wagoneer. Originally intended as a replacement for the Willys Jeep Station Wagon, another legendary offering in its own right, the Wagoneer was an improvement in many ways, especially in regards to off-road capabilities. When compared to other similar offerings from around the car industry, the Wagoneer stood apart as it offered much of the same capabilities but was vastly superior in regards to passenger comforts. What's especially interesting about the Wagoneer is that while its initial run was produced by Jeep, it was later built by American Motors and then swapped again to Chrysler, ending its long production run in the early 90s. Clearly most well known for building over-the-top luxury supercars, Lamborghini less famously also created a line of military-ready SUVs. Based on two prototype vehicles called the LM001 and Cheetah, the LM002 was the first of these SUVs to actually go into production. Interestingly, despite its similar styling, the LM002 was actually a completely unique build that swapped its predecessor's rear-mounted V8 engine for a front-mounted V12, the same one found in the Countach. The LM002, while featuring an all-wheel drive system and a good amount of ground clearance for off-road activity, was a different beast entirely on the inside. You see, this was not a Spartan 4x4 by any stretch, with a wide array of luxury features that rang from high-end leather upholstery to premium stereo and everything in between. The real kicker, however, was that with a special order, this beastly luxury SUV could be equipped with a monstrous 7.2-liter marine V12, the kind found in powerboats. The first British 4x4 bearing the Defender name would be the 1110, named for the length of its wheelbase, boasting a more durable off-road friendly coil spring suspension not found in previous iterations. It was this generation that also saw more focus on interior comfort, putting the future of the company on a path toward luxury SUVs that brilliantly balanced comfort and capability. Although production ceased in 2015, the Defender returned this year and it's been a huge boon for the fans of the range everywhere. Although the Mercedes-Benz G-Class SUV is a German automobile through and through, it came into existence at the behest of the Shah of Iran, a significant shareholder at the time. Originally designed for military use, the 250 GD saw its first civilian version unveiled in 1979. It was so successful in the initial release, it was rebadged as Peugeot P4 for the French market. The G-Class just recently saw a new redesign for the coming years. What's even more impressive is that while the line was officially renamed the G-Class in 1994, the vehicles produced to this day are still very much in line with what Mercedes-Benz first set out to do with the original run of its military 4x4s. Nissan Patrol Y60 was the first in the range to be offered with a coil-sprung suspension, a huge departure from versions that came before it. The Y60 was also fitted with sway bars at the front and back to increase stability, power steering for easier maneuvering, and upgraded brakes. Perhaps the most interesting tidbit of information about this particular model is that from 1988 to 1994, it was sold in Australia as Ford Maverick, not to be confused with the compact car of the same name that was sold in North America and Brazil in the 70s. Known as the J40, FJ40 or simply Land Cruiser, this Toyota 4x4 is actually a Japanese built version of the Willys Jeep used during the World War II. Of course, while the initial version of the Toyota's FJ40 were nearly identical to the Jeep CJ, they didn't stay that way for long. This is because the folks who were building it saw room for significant improvement. Widely considered the best Land Cruiser ever to be built, and with an insanely long production run of 24 years, the FJ40 was a body-on-frame SUV with slightly larger dimension than the Jeep CJ and came with the option for a hard or soft top, gasoline or diesel power plants, low range gearing for better torque response and more. Within 5 years, global production would surpass 50,000 units and make the FJ40 Toyota's best-selling vehicle in the United States. In another 3 years, the number would jump to over 100,000.
Gaz ver, stop etmesin. Geri mi, ileri mi?